He remember me. Yes, way back. Say, yes, stand on there. Yes, stand on there. You may feel like stretching your legs. This brother here, back in 35 now, this is nearly 65. This is 64. That's a long time, isn't it? He known me from 35. I used to room in his house for about 4 or 5 years, I think, in Washington. And he used to go out and bring some of the toughest, is this boys call them cats. Toughest cats he could find. And pick them on me. One day I got to looking at him, I said, he thinks he'll find some cat, yes, that's a louse. I'd whip all of his cats he brings. He'd kick his head and he'd go out after another. Look like he'd say, I will get you after a while. I know one is still real bad. So he'd bring me a real bad one. When he leaves me, I have him all week. So he'd look at me again. Looks like he'd say, where'd this man come from? Right, Brother Bridget. I used to tell him, I said, one of these days, I say, you see, I said, I have a temper right here. I said, you'll be in it, son. You'll be with me then. I says, I will get arrested here. I said, they send me to maybe to prison. I said, but I says, I'll be the winner. We'll have a big temple here one day. So he's eight now.
Yes, sir.
Now way back then, 35. And so I travel up and down the East Coast, running every 2 weeks or 3 weeks, going to another place because the dog would be right there after me. Soon as they chase me, you know, and find me up this tree, I jump to another tree or go in a holler. And so I had to do that for several long years. Yeah. Brother, I here to tell you, he and his wife could give a better, I would say, well, I could use to represent. They could represent me better than anybody on the East Coast. They've known me long. They know me. They know my moral character. He and his wife and some more there in Washington knew me back in those days when I was in my 30s. I was about in my middle 30s, global. And so they know me. They saw me for years, coming in and out. And if you want to know me, you ask them. Ask anybody up and down the East Coast. I stayed up and down there 7 years. In my middle 30s, I'm a young man, up until about 42 years old, or something like that. Yeah, about 44 years old, went to prison. And just go up and down, go behind me where I went along. The people will soon tell you from Boston to Atlanta. And I stopped in and out of every little city, town, all of them. And now today there's a light, a fire burning. Allah has blessed me with temples in every one of these places. Brother can tell you, I would tell him I was at such and such place. He'd come, where you been so long? At such and such place. Now in all those such and such places now, brother, you see a temple in them. Yes, well, Allah blessed me wherever my foot trod, he caused the seed of salvation to prosper there. And it went into the heart of our people, and today there is the old saying goes that cast a bread upon the water and after many days you will see it again. Well, after many years now I see. Yes. So brother didn't think that he'd be standing here today as a minister in those days. But he's there. But he's here. He carried me down in that Virginia and throwed me on one of those bad cats. That cat was so bad he ordered me out in the backyard to a fight. Yes, sir. He was. Yes, sir, brother, I will tell you. After the church, I made fun of him and he felt pretty cheap off of that. But he got jealous because that his followers was there beginning to, you know, to listen at me. And the worst of it, his wife was about to become a convert. So the old ice maker, he just got real angry and just, you know, lost control of himself. Being jealous of me, they're teaching people something that he didn't teach. And they believe in it. And so I laughed at the old brother because I was pretty strong in those days. I was a young fella. And I told brother he wouldn't have lasted 2 minutes if I had went in the backyard. Because the poor brother, he was a little ill, you know, and he was very skinny and he was pretty weak. And I thought more maybe that I could have finished him off in a little while. But that wasn't the point. I wanted to convert him. I wouldn't argue with him. I didn't talk that kind. I made them look pretty cheap for talking to me like he did. Yeah. He didn't have enough truth to fight me with truth. Why now you want to take it out physically? Made a fool out of it. Yes, sir. But this is the thing we must learn to do. Be very diplomatic. Fight whenever, use your fist whenever you got it to do. And then make a good job out of it as you did out of your tongue. All ministers have to be good fighters both ways. Because they can be attacked, all right, don't worry. But so I don't leave everyone to be like myself. I never expect to, you know, to get in no kind of fight physically. Because I believe I can always outwit you with the word. And I will make you come off from that, and after a while you will be shaking my hand. And yet I wouldn't show you that I'm a coward. But I just believe I can outwit you with the word. And have you come down and be my brother after a while. So brothers, here today we talking over this 6 months work. You may be seated, but unless you have something you want to say yourself, in it. Was there anything you want to say yourself?
Yes, I would like to tell my brother here, what is the Holy Apostle in his practice? He's a real fish. And I, as he said, I can bear with it that he knows how to fish. Because I've been around with him, and he was teaching me how to fish. And I didn't realize that until just 2 years ago what he was doing. And I had to do some of the same things that I saw him do out here in my people. That's love enough.